Hi everybody, I hope you're doing okay. Today we're doing the next verse in the Beatitudes, Matthew chapter 5 verse 4, where Jesus tells us, "Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted." It's a promise of God's comfort for us as mourners. I don't think that means God wants us to be miserable. I think it's a truth that there's a lot for us to mourn in this world. We mourn over the loss of loved ones, we mourn over the loss of days gone by that we can't return to. At the moment, we're grieving over the loss of normal life, the lack of daily human interaction. And that's kind of the point. As people who belong to God's kingdom now, we mourn this world of loss and pain and uncertainty. We don't try to get comfortable here in this world that doesn't believe it has a king and make this our home. Things like the coronavirus remind us very forcibly that this is a broken world, far removed from the very good world that God created. This is not life as it's meant to be. And so, as people who belong to God's kingdom now, our natural state is to mourn this kingdom. We belong to the kingdom where everything will be put right, and we mourn the kingdom where so many things are not right. And so as mourners in this world, we won't be comfortable, but the promise of this verse is we will be comforted. God calls himself very specifically in the Bible, the God of all comfort, who will comfort us in all our troubles. And he tells us that in 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 3 and 4. He's telling us that there's no trial too big, no trouble seemingly too small or insignificant. He is here to be our chief comforter through it all. And so we can know his comfort now, today, if we'll rest in his presence, rest in his word. And this comfort is our hope as well. This unrivaled, lasting comfort is what we look forward to when God will wipe every tear from our eye. That very personal image comes up in Revelation 21. This picture of God's care and attention when we meet him face to face on that great and glorious day. It's a picture of his understanding of all that we have been through, all the pains that we have carried, that he wants to be the one to greet us at heaven's door and reassure us that sickness and sadness and death are all in the past. He's not going to deputize that greeting to an angel or to a loved one we're looking forward to meeting past heaven's door. He is going to be the one to greet us, to wipe away the tears, and to welcome us into his eternal comfort. And so our hope in difficult days is that in an uncomfortable world, we know the God of all comfort. In this world of loss, we strain ahead to the world where nothing is ever lost. Let me just pray for us to finish. Heavenly Father, even though we're walking through a valley of uncertainty and darkness, you are with us. Thank you, you are our strength. Thank you for being our comfort. Thank you that that is your promise to us. We ask that you reassure us today and keep us steady in these difficult times. Help us strain ahead all the more for the world we were made for, the world in which you are preparing us a room in your home that we can dwell with you forever. Lord, be our encouragement, be our hope, and be our comfort today. Amen.